All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Trying to get this thing in live real quick because the ladies, oh man, the women's program at Oregon is doing some things. They're going to the Final Four. So I got to talk about it really quickly. I know I got a little late start here. We've been doing some stuff, going some places, doing some things, seeing some people. So I'm sorry I got this a little bit late. But we were in the building on Sunday, and it was one for the ages. One of the best sporting events that I've been to in many years. The atmosphere there was amazing. There was a lot on the line. Both these teams had played each other the last 2 years. Mississippi State, really good team. Really, really, really solid team. Great history. And, you know, amazing game to win. So the fact that Oregon was up against them was huge. They showed up and played really well. Now they get to play Baylor, who's an absolute beast. Got two great girls in the middle, 6'7", 6'4", both of them. Kalani Brown, Lauren Cox, both of those are incredibly good. And, you know, Oregon just hasn't seen the kind of height and size that Baylor has most of the year. So if Oregon wins this game, they're really going to have to out-rebound Baylor. I was at the game, like I said, on Sunday, and that's what I kept talking to people in my little corner about. Again, growing up in the basketball community, growing up as a basketball player and as a coach most of my adult life, you got to win the boards. You know, you hear a coach talk about it all the time. You got to clean the glass. You got to get those boards. And they did a really good job against Mississippi State. If Oregon can do that against Baylor, then they might be in this. They also got to make their threes. They're a really, really good three-point shooting team. Got to make the threes. Everybody's got to do it. Sabrina Ionescu, probably the best point guard in the country on the women's side, and she's had a phenomenal year. And, you know, it's just been a great year. So the fact that it's come down to this, the fact that they get to go to the Final Four is pretty amazing. So I think that if you look at Oregon, you know, it's kind of a Cinderella thing for them. The fact that they get to get a chance to go to the Final Four, really represent the Pac-12. I think it's a phenomenal thing. What gives me hope is the fact that Baylor's one loss did come to Stanford. Oregon's had some success against Stanford. Stanford also beat Oregon at the end of the year, but I do think that it's one of those deals where, you know, if you get right down to it, Oregon can hang with these guys. Satu Sabally has had a great year this year. Aaron Bowley's had a great year this year. Obviously, if you can shoot the ball from outside with a little bit of height, I think you can really do really well in the women's game. I coached women's basketball for a while when I first got out of college, and it is a different game. It doesn't play as extreme as some of the guys' stuff, but they have their own level of greatness inside the women's game. So if you can really tap in and really get into that, I know a lot of guys who I talk with, I work with a lot of guys who are into sports and coach and whatnot, and there's a lot of guys who are anti. They don't want anything to do with WNBA. They don't really want to watch any of that sort of stuff. But I've seen some great players come through Portland. One of the best players I've ever seen is a girl named Shoni Schimmel. Went into the WNBA, did amazing things. Got to see her firsthand right there, coaching against her team and whatever. So just it's really cool to see. So it's good to see now Oregon starting to enter into that upper echelon of the women's college basketball. Like I've said before, it's very difficult to kind of break into that. And so, you know, Baylor's definitely there. You know, two-time national champion, including a year going 40-0, pretty impressive. So, hats off to the Ducks. Cheers to Baylor. You know, if Baylor wins, then great. They get to go to again another national championship opportunity. But if the Ducks win, they might have something really, really special on hand if they could get it done. Again, trying to get through Notre Dame or getting through UConn or getting through some of those upper echelon teams, very, very difficult to do. But this might be the year. You never know. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Thank you very much. Really appreciate it. Go Ducks.